Construction started in 1907. It's finished in 1909. The site is supposed to be located on an Indian burial ground, and I believe they actually had to repel a few Indian attacks as they were building it.
And then, I mean, if you end up deciding to have kids someday, yeah, I mean, it's a great place for them to grow up.
Perfect.
So what do you think of the house?
I love it. It has great energy. Thank you so much.
Yeah, well, if you say so, I guess that's all that's left to do is just sign the paperwork.
Okay, let's get to it.
Now, I am required to disclose any crimes that have occurred here within the last 2 years.
Okay.
The previous owners were murdered under somewhat mysterious circumstances.
What do you mean? What happened?
Well, I'm not 100% sure, but rumor has it, this house is built on an ancient Indian burial ground.
You know what? I think I'll just take my chances.
The Indian burial ground trope began with a book called The Amityville Horror, written in the late 1970s. From this book, a trend began with other books, films, and TV shows using the trope throughout the late 1980s and 90s, until the trope became stale, ordinary, and expected due to its excessive overuse. The motif quickly lost its ability to frighten, and instead gained the reputation of being comical.
Man, this place has got everything!
An ancient Indian what?
And is this in case the house sneezes?
No, that's the ghost for the attic.
I don't want a ghost.
Well, nobody wants a ghost. But you've got one. Because the house is sitting on an ancient Indian burial ground.
Wait a minute. The house was built on radioactive waste and an ancient Indian burial ground. That would never happen.
Okay, obviously you don't know much about the U.S. government.
Mr. Plute, Homer Simpson here. When you sold me this house, you forgot to mention one little thing. You didn't tell me it was built on an Indian burial ground! No, you didn't! Well, that's not my recollection. Yeah, well, all right, goodbye. He says he mentioned it 5 or 6 times.
Okay, let's talk. What do you want to talk about?
The burial ground trope is popular for many reasons. The first is our country's obsession with the bad Indian. Non-natives often view Indians in a negative light due to many natives' refusal to assimilate into American culture. Natives are often seen as being opposed to colonialism, and in their savage nature, ruthlessly try to rid the world of colonialism. Another reason for our obsession with the Indian burial ground trope is that non-natives know very little about various native cultures, making them seem mystical and even magical. Non-natives may believe that one of the mystical powers of Indians is to come back from the dead in spirit form, making native culture an easy target for horror and satirical films. Non-natives have an ingrained fear of retribution from natives. This fear is commonly referred to as white guilt, and it comes from all of the atrocious events that natives have suffered and continue to suffer through today. White storytellers may be aware of the guilt and place the Indian in a place of power where they can get revenge for the crimes committed against them. The bones of American Indians are some of the oldest remains that humans have access to. Science is one of the largest rationales for recovering Native remains from their places of rest. The argument is that because the remains are being used for educational and scientific purposes, it is somehow acceptable. The remains are often placed on shelves and in museums next to pottery and arrowheads to be seen as specimens and not as real people. Across almost every culture, a lasting burial ground is a rite that is believed to be necessary for everyone. Unfortunately, this rite is not afforded to Native Americans.
Yeah, it's awesome. I just moved in. I'm unpacking boxes right now.
You love it.
I love it. It's amazing.
I know you've been looking for a while. Well, by the way.
Yeah, thanks. You'll have to come over. What are you doing tomorrow?
Probably nothing.
Well, come over. I've got wine. I've got...
I can put some stuff.
Hold on.
Hello?
That was weird. The lights just flickered, but it's nothing. So. How was your date last night? Good. So where did you guys go?
Here's Johnny.
Hello? Oh my god. Maybe that realtor was right. Maybe this place is haunted.
The Smithsonian has over 18,000 Native bodies. Sadly, this has become a normal occurrence throughout historical and scientific fields, although it would never be deemed necessary or acceptable for museums to house and display the remains of thousands of any other group of people.
All right. Almost there, Lois.
What is this place?
This was their burial ground.
Whose burial ground?
Mi'kmaq Indians. I brought you here to bury Ellen's cat.
Good, guys. Do you remember something that Mary Brown said the other day? What was the story from the Bible that she was telling us? Fuck, I wasn't listening to her because I thought she was a lunatic. It was Esau, but it was something about a pile of rocks.
Oh, she was totally telling us about a rock.
What the fuck was it about a pile of rocks? Does anybody remember? Dude, live your life.
This is like...
Live your life.
It's like an Indian burial ground, man.
You're saying if I dig up my son's body and rebury him at the old Indian burial ground that I...
Don't do it, Sarge.
The person you put up there ain't the person that comes back.
What comes out of the ground ain't the thing you put in. The Indians knew that.
They stopped using that burial ground when the ground went sour.
That's why they stopped using it when the ground went sour. I'm just here to talk you out of it. Don't bury your son's body at the Indian Burial Ground, Starch. The one that's right up over there, behind the Anderson's barn. Sometimes...
Dad is better.
Dad is better.
Paperwork. Now it just details some of the issues and general maintenance that you'll need for this house. All standard stuff, really. Maybe just some new pipe work, probably some electrical work, just things like that.
That sounds really expensive. Should have told me that earlier. But that definitely explains the noises last night and the lights flickering, so thanks, I guess.
Well, maybe it was the ancient Indian spirits trying to tell you something.
Oh, I don't think so. And you actually probably shouldn't go around saying that. It's really disrespectful, and it contributes to this awful stereotype about American Indians.
Mm. I'm really sorry. I guess I never really thought of it like that.
Here's Johnny!
It has great energy.
Well. Oh, wait. You put the... I think it's the wrong names. Hold on.
Did I do the wrong
thing? The next one's Rachel, but I think it's supposed to be Kim.
Oh, okay.
Aww. That's fine. Really great neighborhood. I mean, great schools. It's a really great place for kids to grow up. You can really have kids one day.
I can't have kids.
Thank you for letting me stop by. I just wanted to drop off some more paperwork. My office made a little oopsie, and we forgot to give you some of the truth and... We forgot to give you
some of the truth.
Some of the truth.
It is true, yeah. Keep going.
Okay. My office made a little oopsie and forgot to give you the truth and sale of housing paperwork. Now, it just details some of the issues and general maintenance that the house needs. All standard stuff. Maybe some new pipes, probably some new electrical work, stuff like that.
Oh, is that all?
Maybe that's a bad one.
Thanks for letting me stop by. I just wanted to drop off some more paperwork. My office made a little oopsie. We forgot to give you the truth and sale of housing paperwork. It just details some of the issues and general maintenance that the house needs. All standard stuff. Maybe some new piping. Probably some new electrical work. Stuff like that.
Is that all?
No.
God damn it.